I am grateful for the increase in this budget of $166 million into basic education, a 2.6% increase over last year. I'm also grateful for the $50 million more in special education and the $25 million in pre-K. But, Mr. Speaker, this increase is not, I repeat, is not keeping pace with the increasing costs of charters and cyber charters in my district, Mr. Speaker, a serious issue that's not being dealt with in this budget. And this, Mr. Speaker, is causing some of my school districts that struggle to raise property taxes. Mr. Speaker, at the same time, the proposed budget places $300 million more into the rainy day fund. Sounds like a good idea. How about this idea? Why didn't we take the $300 million and put that into the basic ed and put the $166 million into the rainy day fund? That would have helped our school districts a lot better than what's going on now with that. And it will help stop property tax increases that we're all going to see from this budget in some form or another. Another issue I have, Mr. Speaker, is whether the school safety was with the school safety grant program. Last year, five of my school districts got zero in school safety grant money. Now, I understand we're putting $45 million more into it, and I'm grateful for that, but no one, Mr. Speaker, can tell me what, if anything, my districts are getting. Again, five of my districts got zero last year, and that's unacceptable because we've had some problems in those schools. Another problem I see, Mr. Speaker, with the budget is a decrease in transportation funding. Why are we cutting $366 million out of transportation? Talking with PennDOT today, we still have 2,839 structurally deficient bridges, and we're cutting $366 million. I don't understand that. And I don't understand why we're cutting another $111 million from mass transit. That, to me, is unacceptable. We're going to hurt the transit authorities and the ridership. Lastly, Mr. Speaker, there are many other things lacking in this budget, like the minimum wage and other things noted earlier. But, Mr. Speaker, I urge a no vote on this budget because we can and should do better for the people of Pennsylvania. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.